Greetings, fellow citizens, and now for something completely different. In my ship toughness tests, I use high alpha damage, and ships with a lot of shield HPs are looking good. Now, I know perfectly well that this might not be your daily experience when you are dogfighting. Well, we do have high alpha damage, missile and torpedo damage, but we also have dogfights with guns, where your ship is hit a little bit, then you are doing some evasive maneuvers, and then your ship gets hit a little bit again. Today we are testing constant lowish damage. Now I know this is artificial too, and this is not your typical dogfighting experience, but it's a good test to see how useful stealth shields are. Stealth shields have a very high regen rate and no regen delay damaged, but they don't give a lot of shield HPs. So if you are not constantly in a high alpha damage situation, you might want to use one or two stealth shields in your loadout mix. We will use two size 3 Penta laser repeaters, non-overclocked, and our target will be a Saber with 3 all stops, with 2 force walls and 1 all stops. Hey, I don't have 3 force walls and CIG still doesn't make them available in Arena Commander. A Saber with 3 whales and with 3 shimmers. I will shoot the 2 size 3 Penta laser repeaters with 880 DPS until the target is destroyed or until the guns are overheating. By the way, you can also see that the Saber has very bad shield holes, but more about this later. Here are the shields we are testing today. Shimmers, Veils, All Stops and Force Walls. I won't test Mirage because you cannot rent Mirage in Arena Commander, and I'm not willing to spend 2 hours in the universe and get a crime stat. So let's talk about power up time. This is the stat many people, including myself, didn't care for 2 weeks ago, but it's very important. So what is this? There's a power bar above your shield pie chart. And when you're starting a ship, this bar is at 0. This is text. So bar is at 0. And then this bar is ramping up to max. And your shields are only regenerating at this rate when this bar is at max. And this takes time. When you're starting from a cold ship, it takes 5 seconds for shimmers, 4 for whales, 12 all stops, 11 force walls and 21 for Mirage until your shields are regenerating at this rate. And I so hope that this is a mistake, because Mirage shields have so nice stats, but they have this stupid 21 second power up time. Yes, this must be a bug. I am so close to create an IC report, but maybe it's intentional. This wouldn't be so bad if it would be only important when you are starting your ship, but it's also important when your shields are full and idle. In this case, the power bar is already in, about 25%, but it has to ramp up when you are taking damage, even when your shields have no regen delay damage. And only when this bar is at max, your shields are regenerating at this rate. And this still takes time. In this case, the power up time is around half this time. I didn't measure it very correctly, so this is roughly spoken. But yeah, even with full shields and idle, and when your shields have no regen delay damaged, when you are taking damage, it takes time until your shields are ramping up and regenerating at this rate. So this is very bad for Mirage, because for Mirage this takes around 11 seconds, while this takes only around 2 seconds for Veils. And one more reason why this is so bad, you will see this very shortly. Even when your ship is getting hit constantly by damage every other second, your power bar goes back to idle occasionally, so it has to ramp up again. And this isn't a huge problem when your power uptime is 5 seconds or 4 divided by 2, of course, but this is a huge problem when it takes 11 seconds. I hope you know now why this is so important, even when shields are at max, idle, no region delay damaged and your ship is taking damage. This power bar has to ramp up first. And only when this power bar is at max, you are regenerating at this rate. First test, 3 all stops, and we are shooting 2 size 3 Penta laser repeaters. Start. Front shield is going down, no region, because region delay damaged. And now we are taking a lot of damage and we are destroyed. Now we have 2 force walls and 1 all stop. Start. Front shield face is going down, no region. Now it's down to 0, we are taking damage and center is red. Destroyed. Now we have 3 whales, let's see how this goes. Start. Front shield face is taking damage, but now the region rate is at max and we have no region delay damaged. This means we can take this damage. But you can see that the power bar is going down to idle occasionally, so the shields have to get powered up again. And here whales really, really shine with a very low power uptime of 4 seconds. It's actually lower when the bar is already idle. Yeah, look at this, we can do this forever if we want to. Now the guns are overheated. I wait a little bit and then we go more. And start. You can see the power up bar going up to max. Now we are at max region rate and we can deal with the incoming damage. But you can see that the power up bar is going down to idle occasionally, even though we are constantly hit and going up again. Yeah, it was idle again and again at max region rate. This is actually funny, and guns are overheating again. And in case you are wondering why I am a little bit pitched up, it's because Sabre has very bad shield holes at the cockpit. If I do this in this setup, I'm gonna die because of the shield holes. But you could easily clearly see that the Sabre with 3 whales can deal with this damage. So let's check out the shield hole. Yeah, this was a shield hole. I mean, we could do this damage, we could take this damage forever. But when we hit the shield hole, it's just passing through and destroying our ship. Yeah. And now we have 3 size 1 shimmers. Start. Front shield face is taking damage, but the power-up bar is getting up to max, and now we are regenerating at max rate. Front shield face is slowly getting back to full. Power-up bar stays at max, and now it went back to idle for a very short moment, and we have to ramp up again, and now we are again at max regenerate. We are slowly getting back to full shields. And now power up bar was again at idle and has to ramp up again to max. But we can deal with the damage and now guns are overheated. And I want to show you the shield hole again. When I do this in this configuration, it shouldn't be any different, just a few degrees. Some of the shots will pass through the shield hole and destroy the silver start. Not yet. Saber has very, very bad shield holes. What did we learn? We learned the Saber has terrible shield holes around the cockpit, which is really, really bad. And when shields are idle and taking damage, it takes time until those ramp up. And I said power-up time is roughly spoken half this value, but it might be more like two-thirds of this value. Maybe I measure it more correctly in the future. But yeah, it still takes time. And this is very bad for Mirage Shields with this very bad power-up time of 21 seconds. So it still takes 11 to 16 seconds for Mirage to power up when your shields are taking damage. And even when you are getting hit constantly, this power bar can go back to idle occasionally. We also learned that it's a very good idea to have at least one stealth shield in your mix. I mean one Veil or one Shimmer, not one Mirage. If you are not getting hit by high alpha damage, the one stealth shield gives you always a high regen rate because you have no regen delay damaged. And we also learned if the Saber wouldn't have this terrible shield hole around the cockpit, and if the Saber has three Veils or three Shimmers, you can shoot two size 3 Pentalaser repeaters all day long at her without doing any damage. So I hope you learned something. I hope you had fun watching this video, and see you next time. Bye. Auf Wiedersehen.
Well, one way or another, we'll find out what Flash is made of. I guarantee you that.
Isn't that the guy from Star Wars?